because people are blinded by idolatry. They're blinded. They think they understand the Word of God, but the reason why they don't want you reading the Word of God is because there's nothing in the Bible that supports and defends anything that comes out of Roman Catholicism. So the Word of God must be wrong if they're right. And as Christians behind the pulpit, you know better. And as Christians who are sitting in the pews, you know better. Your righteousness must exceed that of the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees. The seven eyes of the seventh spirit. These eyes, they're doing the watching, right? They're watchers. Eyes watch. This crop circle was not done by the hands of man. There is definite proof of that. There are eyewitness accounts. Even black op helicopters have chased these balls of light around and have tried to catch them, tried to stop them, but they cannot. Why cannot? Because they are concentrated spirit. They are God's seven spirits. He tells us what they are. He lets us know in his word that he's sending them into the world. Why? Lucifer once carried them. He carried them throughout the congregation to bring praise and worship to the Son of God. He carried them. And he refused to have them. Jesus had all seven of them. Solomon had the spirit of wisdom. Concentrate the lamps of God from the throne room of God. Seven eyes are the seven spirits of God. You see the four eyes there, the four eyes with the irises, with the conjuncta, and then the three circles. So there's four, and you count the three circles, gives you seven. But there are actually 14 raised parts there, and I show you what that is. But let's go to Revelation 5, 6. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne, and the four beasts, in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb, as it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent forth into all the earth. Pay attention. Seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent forth into all the earth. So what are they trying to do when they're chasing the black hawk helicopters and seeing? They're trying to poke out God's eyes. These are his eyes. The seven eyes are the seven spirits of God, the lamps of God. And how do we know that they're the lamps of God? Well, we go back down here and we take a look. There are seven, the four eyes, the seven circles, you know, with the three circles, makes up seven. Very clever. See, not everybody would look at this, not understand what he's doing here, what he's saying, saving it, reserving it for one individual, as he promised 500 years before Jesus Christ came into the earth. He said he would send forth a king, and a king would stand up, a fierce countenance who understood dark sentences, and he would destroy wonderfully the mighty and the holy people. Well, that's wicked mighty and wicked holy people, because, well, what Lucifer did in heaven, I get to do right here. Praise be to Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. So, Psalm 14, 1 through 7, the fool has said in his heart, there are 14 raised sections, by the way. There are 14 raised sections. You got 12 with the eyes. And then in the circle number 6, you got the upper and lower that have like the scalloping, you know, the fancy artwork there around that eye, that section of the eye in position 6. So there's 14 raised sections here. So if we go to Psalm 14, 7, 1 through 7. The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. They have done abominable works. There is none that doeth good. The Lord looked down. This is the eyes of God. The Lord looked down from heaven upon the children of men to see if there were any that did understand and seek God. I seek God. That's how I get to do this. I seek God. I'm searching for God. I'm always looking for what God is up to. What is God doing? Because I know that God doesn't want us here to be punished by this system that they're building for us. They're building us a Nazi system. And God's going to take us out of here to leave them behind in their very own gallows. Verse 3. They are all gone aside. They are all become filthy. There is none that doeth good, no, not one. Have all the workers of iniquity no knowledge? We read up about iniquity. The iniquity is going to be left behind for the very fires that they built for themselves. Who eat up my people as they eat bread and call not upon the Lord. That's them. They send us to war after war after war. They eat us up like bread. There were they in great fear, for God is in the generation of the righteous. You have shamed the counsel of the poor because the Lord is his refuge. Oh, that the salvation of Israel were come out of Zion. When the Lord bringeth back the captivity of his people, Jacob shall rejoice and Israel shall be glad. The captivity of his people brought back into Zion. Israel comes to Zion. We're going to take a look at a passage in Isaiah. And it's going to become a very familiar passage to you because it talks about the twin towers. It talks about when the towers fall. And it is a revelation. We know that the twin towers fell in 2001. And, well, God knows who's behind that, who he's holding responsible for that. There is a crop circle here called the twins. Episode 11. Episode 11, dealing with the twin towers in God's design there. If a couple of drunk guys went out with planks and built this thing, why would they do something like this? And how accurate is this? Will they extend the both towers at either end with a line? And you cannot mistake what God is trying to reveal to us here is that he wants us to wrap that line around the earth to see where the true axis of evil truly lies. Remember this axis of evil that we were fighting? Well, this is the axis and whom God is holding responsible for the problems of our world because the word of God wasn't preached by them, wasn't taught by them, wasn't revealed by them. They kept it away from the masses, and they kept their little religiosity working. When the priesthood had been destroyed in 70 AD, the devil had to rise it back up 300 years later, 220 years later, with Constantine brought back the priesthood. The church was doing fine without them. We didn't need their help. And in fact, they kept it away so that 200 years, they had it in their possession for 200 years before Muhammad showed up. They could have gone out and loved and won these people to Christ, but they didn't do that. They kept their paganism. They attached the word to their paganism, and now that's where we are today. Their paganism has followed them all the way to the end and has destroyed everything that they've touched. The Mayans, the Incans, and now it's the Americans' turn. They destroyed Germany because Germany had the Gutenberg press, printed up Bibles. Every place where the Bible was in free to go, they've had to destroy it. Why? Because it harms their money at the top of the hill. Every time we win a soul away from them, it takes money out of their mouths. So we are the bad ones. We're the bad ones because their God is money. Their God is money. Their money sits in the Rothschild's banking system. And it's invested in this war machine. And they're making interest on it as our children go to war and die in the wars that they create and stir up. When they came in here and took $700 billion from our housing market, it was mentioned, the same figure was mentioned at the Saddleback debates. George Bush came forth and the kids at Yale University were working, these power moguls, these people in political positions, in money positions of power, were making sure that when the right time came, that this right man was in office at the right time. And they were trying to make it to Bush to fulfill a prophecy that they had made back there at Yale University. They wanted the American public to know what was going on. George Bush was the last president of the United States of America before the Antichrist came into power. And who put the Antichrist into power? Who put the person who's going to destroy America and destroy the American people and who's going to bring in new Nazi Germany? They put him in office. Now, you may go to the election polls, and of course he can't have a 2-year term unless, of course, he starts a World War III, which leaves him in power. Or martial law, and they've given themselves all these executive orders and to usurp the Constitution anytime that they want now. Or even that when you went to the polls the last time, both candidates were put in there by the same people. We weren't getting the White House back. Once you give it to the devil, you're not getting it back. Rome has everything. Everything now belongs to Rome. Now we have the return of Christ, but guess who's staying behind? Rome. That's why they're talking about aliens and UFOs now, because the demons are trying to set them up for their fall. So that when the church is taken out of the earth, they can sit there and say, well, it was the aliens and UFOs, but we're for pro-life. Wink, wink. Nod, nod. We stand around and we pick it with you. But if we had let the word of God go forth and everybody was getting saved when they should have been stopped, well, we wouldn't have had picket lines, period. But we're for pro-life. Don't be fooled by darkness. Don't be fooled. Light comes into the world and shines in the darkness, and the darkness hasn't comprehended it. The lamps that Lucifer once carried, throughout the congregation to bring praise and worship, God has blessed this one man, the one who comes to destroy wonderfully the works of the mighty and the holy people. Seven eyes of the seven spirits of God. Getting back. I put a video here. Below the video is an eyewitness testimony of the lamps of God known by unbelievers as balls of light, actually filmed and pursued. So you can watch the video. You can see there are two more witnesses. I went and tried to tell a man whom I had a great deal of respect for, someone who was there at my divorce when I got divorced, a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, who now in Tennessee, used to be in Massachusetts. He's like, he looked, just the coldness. It was just, I couldn't believe how cold he was to me when I revealed what was, oh, these are all done by men. He bought into the lie. He bought the lie. You know, he fell for the lie. Someone destroyed his ministry here in Massachusetts and sent them away, but God was going to use that man to win a lot of people in Massachusetts. So that those people who were touched by the Holy Spirit of God would have gone out and touched other people. And it would have been a great revival and fire, but that's not going to happen now because George Bailey has left Bedford Falls. And the people who caused him to leave Bedford Falls, well, they have parochial school background and they champion the whore and the harlot now. And they're saying that they've got, and they sing wonderfully. They have great ministry. I've been in worship. They have wonderful worship. And they call on the name of the Lord and they praise and they worship and they read Bible passages and they have Bible ministry and if you look back at Joseph, he had interpreted a dream in prison. There was the baker and there was the chief butler. There was the chief, the chief of staff of the Pharaoh. And the chief of staff was reinitiated, but the baker was assassinated, was killed. Anybody can prepare food, brothers and sisters in Christ, but there can only be one chief butler. And this was a game of finding out, replace Lucifer. We're all here to replace him. When you see the high priest in the tabernacle in the wilderness wearing all the stones, that's man raised up to replace him in the tabernacle. Hey, you take a look at the ephod, stone for stone, and go back to Ezekiel 28, where Lucifer, God talks about the creation of Lucifer, and he talks about every stone, stone for stone, ephod, Lucifer. God was letting his enemy know, you weren't going to worship me, I'm taking the dust of the ground, and I'll raise it up to worship me. He was waiting for someone to see the truth out there in Egypt. He says, if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men unto me. When he said tag, I was it. I knew that we are at the end. I know that this is the call. This is the big one. But in his love, in his infinite wisdom, in his infinite care for mankind, this man that he has chosen he's not chosen me. He sent me and played this little game of little hide and seek. The enemy built wanted to play King of the Hill and hid this thing using slaves for 400 years to hide it. When I found it and knew where it truly belonged in the picture, that the Son of God didn't belong in the dirt, he gave this to me and started giving me his lamps. And they've been coming gradually. They haven't come all at once. I couldn't handle it all at once. The first lamp I got, I almost started tearing down pulpits and telling ministers because I could see the truth. I could see that they were, I could see the darkness in them. I could see that they were misleading people. I could see they would just, and it was making me angry because I couldn't see why they couldn't see it. Why can't you see your error? Why can't you see that you destroyed a great ministry in Boston and all those people will now no longer be touched? Those people that were supposed to be getting saved, the man whom God was going to raise up because he got in trouble by the state. The state took him to task and God was going to take him and make him the most powerful man within the state would have brought many of those people to repentance in Massachusetts. Will it happen now?